if you have heard about Kanuga, you need to come here. When I was growing up, our rector was Bob Hayden, and he was always talking about Kanuga and having groups come to Kanuga. And for various reasons, none of which were very good, I didn't get up here for about 20 years. And I thought, I sure wish I had come here when I first heard about it.
I do feel that for so many reasons, this is holy ground. And I think it's almost by virtue of its location, it's a thin place, but also it's all the years of people praying, people gathering, people being an intentional Christian community. It's that sense of a foretaste of heaven, you know, the foretaste of the kingdom. And I really feel that when I'm here. And you try to take it back with you and you keep it as much as you can, but I like that I can come up here a number of times a year, get that wee boost, you know. So it's really special. It's really special. And I love all the chapels. St. Francis is my favorite because, you know, I've seen bunnies and you listen to the brook and, you know, I do always do the early morning Eucharist when we're here. And it's just so special because you do feel, you know, part of the community is being in communion with nature. The community for me and community is a lot of different things. Some of it is the community of people. We've been coming Thanksgiving for like 20 years and missed, you know, a few years with COVID and whatnot, but pretty steady for those 20 years. And we still see some people that we met, you know, close to 20 years ago.
Kanuga seems affirming on every level to me. And I think that spills over into how you relate to one another and how you approach other people here and beyond here when you go home. And I think that that's a big part of it. You kind of, rather than being defensive, your natural inclination is to reach out a little or embrace a little where you might not have otherwise.
We don't have kids, so it's fun to see other people's kids, you know, over the years. And you just can't believe, because you feel like you haven't aged at all. How can they have gotten bigger? So it's fun. It gives you a chance to see other people's children and be in a multi-generational community that we don't really have so much, you know, in our little household.
More than once summer when we've been here, we've had a young person, a child that was maybe 7, 8 years old, volunteer to help with the evening prayer services, to read or lead things. And I think that means a lot to both to the children, the child that does it, and to everyone else.
Sat down there to eat, and I literally felt like my shoulders relaxed. I didn't even know I was holding tension. You know, you don't know you're always holding tension. But everything just kind of went, ah. And it was just this huge feeling of just the peace washing over me. It's just so peaceful and restful. And a lot of vacations are not restful. And sometimes you want an unrestful vacation, but if you want a restful vacation, I don't think you can be Kanuga. That's one thing I think that contributes to the sense of community is the staffers who stay, get the spirit. And it's like, we saw Tony at breakfast. We saw Tony at 11 o'clock last night as he was leaving after being our bartender down for Hops and Hams. And he smiled to see you at breakfast. You know, these people are, they're part of the spirit of Kanuga. Because their heart is, you know, you go some places and they almost bark at you, you know, if you need anything or just even to check you in or whatever. And the people who are here and, you know, Kate, I've known forever, it seems like. The people who have been here and work more the customer service every day kind of thing, they have something in them that is part of the spirit of Kanuga. And they're part of it. I mean, I look forward to seeing the staff people, you know, like I do my, you know, people that I have met here, because they're just, that sense of the loving and the, you know, the best Christian sense of the loving community.
There's kind of a family aspect quality to it in some ways. Last night we were singing a song about Kanuga toast, and it was a lot. Everybody, you know, had that experience and could share it and with affection, and it something you don't see very often outside of a family, and sometimes not that often within a family.
You can't charge enough for what people receive here to make it, being a small enough, smallish place, to make enough money to support the grounds and to maintain it. But if, for those of us who do believe it's a holy place, a thin place, it's important that it continue. We want to continue in our lifetime. We want to continue past our lifetime.